Star Trek now is 47 years old. It is an extraordinary phenomenon. Gene Roddenberry created Star Trek, but this longevity was created by the fans. And I go to these conventions, whether it be specifically Star Trek conventions or sci-fi and comics and anime, because it's an opportunity for us to say thank you for their devotion, their passion, their love that's created this phenomenon and this incredible longevity. In 3 more years, Star Trek will be celebrating its golden anniversary. And they're the ones that are giving us this gift.
Did you ever think, and once again, this was a TV show that was only on for 3 years. You were a young actor. Did you ever think when you were doing it, oh, this isn't a job. This is now an iconic piece of American culture that will survive me. Did you have any sense at the time how important it would end up being?
Well, when fans give me that kind of praise, and because we actors have egos, I say yes, because we are visionaries. When we were filming the pilot film, I said, and in the 21st century, we will be gathering here in Atlanta. No, we had no idea. As a matter of fact, at the beginning of each episode, we announced that we were boldly going on a 5-year mission. 5 years. We discovered that the most destructive adversary were not the Klingons, but the NBC programming executives, because they terminated us after 3 years.
So how do you explain the longevity of this, the fact that not only do people remember the series, but it has spawned other television series, it has spawned movies, it has spawned a whole subculture? Why?
Well, the programming executives had no idea of the fans. We were canceled after 3 years because the ratings were low. However, the fans were there. The programming executives didn't know when and where to program us. The third season was on Friday nights at 10 o'clock. That's the morgue hour. The with it, intelligent, hip kids are on Friday nights out. But when we got canceled and we went into syndication and they programmed us at an accessible, logical hour for Star Trek fans, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday at 8, 9, 10 o'clock, then the ratings soared. And they discovered that there indeed is an audience out there. And so 10 years after we were canceled, we came back as a major feature film, and the box office exploded, hence the sequels. And now we have J.J. Abrams doing, I think, the 14th version of Star Trek. It's an amazing phenomenon. And then we've had the spin-off series, The Next Generation, Voyager, Enterprise, so forth.